the engineer of the 21st century is quite different from the engineer of the last century. The education was very siloed and disciplinary. Today, engineering is really a team sport, so you cannot solve any of the pressing societal problems by just knowing your discipline. You have to have a team of people together who are going to look at it from every point of view and try to find a solution together.
The Makerspace at its core is a prototyping lab, so that means we have all of the tools and machines you could imagine to work on projects, hands-on, hardware-based projects. Things like 3D printers, laser cutters, soldering and PCB production equipment, shop tools, even sewing and embroidery. We focus on helping students learn how to use the equipment here for themselves, empowering them to be able to really create whatever they would like. Some of the important elements or resources here in the Makerspace are projects like the Urban Food Lab, the Robotics Lab, our machine shop, the Maker Garage, and our integrated advanced manufacturing resources. It's open to all of NYU. It's not just for engineers. And we really encourage students from all different schools and majors to come into the space. And I think that that really contributes to that feeling of creativity and that community of collaboration.
The Makerspace at NYU Tandon School of Engineering is this really brilliant crossroads where you get to try anything you want to, regardless of where you came from. I'm a rising senior majoring in politics, and I'm the student director of the Urban Food Lab here at NYU. I manage a team of about 15 undergraduate students, and what we do is we produce food without any soil and work with a lot of local community organizations to spread awareness and education on alternative farming techniques that actually don't use as many resources as traditional farming. And it's also a great way to teach anyone about how the food system works. It's one thing to just read about our specific techniques of alternative farming in a book, but you won't really understand it until you put your hands on these plants and done it yourself.
The Experiential Learning Center is a new initiative at Tandon. We focus on encouraging experiential learning throughout the curriculum for both personal and academic projects to really build the intrinsic motivation of students and their design self-efficacy. The Vertically Integrated Projects Program is a consortium of universities who offer hands-on experiential learning for course credit. Tandon offers over 40 such courses. Students can work in these teams and courses on large-scale, multidisciplinary teams to create advanced projects.
I work under the Smart Wearables BioTracker VIP. Our ultimate goal is basically to create smart wearable devices that can detect muscle contraction signals during gestures and use these signals to a machine learning algorithm for gesture classification and prediction. Our wearable devices are geared towards medical use, industrial use, and AR and VR utility. For medical use, we want to focus on stroke patients, Parkinson's patients, and amputees, and help them move in a more seamless way compared to how they would use a passive prosthesis nowadays. The Makerspace has become kind of like my second laboratory after the Merit Lab. It's basically where I spend a lot of time with prototyping and assembling our hardware. So for prototyping, I do a lot of 3D printing and CNC milling, and it's become an essential part in my experiential learning here at NYU Tandon to become the engineer that I want to be.
At every point in their education, students are actually presented with opportunities to really see how they would go about solving such a problem in the real world. How to perhaps pitch an idea to a company. Many of these teams are sponsored by companies, in fact, solving a real world problem that they need.
Merit Lab is short for Medical Robotics and Interactive Intelligent Technologies Lab. So what we are doing in Merit Lab always revolves around the medical sector, although we are all engineers there. One of my research is revolving around wearable systems with which we are trying to collect different biomarkers such as temperature of the patient, heart rate, and oxygen saturation, as well as step count and tracking of the patient using the Bluetooth low energy technology. So I have to thank Makerspace for allowing us to use all the tools and machine and all the access that they have been given us so that this idea could come alive finally. We were able to make something flexible so it can be generalizable to the forehead of the subjects that are going to be wearing this, as well as the robustness of the sensors that are being on the forehead for good skin contact and data acquisition.
In addition to NYU affiliates, we also historically have a very welcoming, strong K-12 STEM center. This center has run programs that are open and free to local, middle, and high school students. Those students have the opportunity to come into the Makerspace each summer as they participate in those programs.
I would say that Makerspace is really the heart of our School of Engineering. It's really what visually and viscerally gives you the idea of what we do here, mostly through students. But let's not forget that behind this, there is a lot of faculty hours invested into the students and their education. So seeing them all in one place is really something that gives us a lot of hope for the future.